Hello, Funk. Have you heard of Team Comtris 2? Master Config made TF2 source code public. I do know what that is. And people are improving it publicly with the goal that Valve will accept it. Also, practice your base. To answer your question, I do know what Team Comtris is. I don't know the full details of it, but from what I know from that leaked TF2 source code, someone kind of scrummaged around and organized stuff and added some really useful commands. I think they added one command. In CSGO, you can change where your view model is on the XYZ axis. You'll notice that TF2 only has the minimized view models where they move them downwards and they look shitty and they aim at a weird angle. Apparently, it's possible to have custom XYZ coordinates through a command, but Valve hasn't implemented that. That's the kind of stuff I would love to see come out of Team Comtris. Quality of life, modern day, the stuff that TF2 is good at, you know? Letting players customize. It's more than commands. Oh, I know that I'm sure they're running through material files and optimizing performance, but I meant specifically of what I know about it. That's the stuff that most interests me. Anyways, hello everyone that's here. I have a Minecraft server. You couldn't tell by the last 20 streams. Again, anyone that's a sub can join. It's vanilla. You don't need any shit to get on. Let me know if the audio is okay. I wouldn't mind having music on in the background this stream, but I don't want it loud. I'm still recovering from PTSD of the speak command, so I'm just making sure everything is all right. Check your mailbox. I can do that. I'm on my way. Gonna lower the audio level a little bit to make sure that it works out well. At what time are we PvPing? Well, it kind of depends on what the turnout is. If we only have 5 people, we'll probably at best we can run some 1v1 scrims. Again, if you have access to the server and you want to PvP, or even if you just want to spectate matches, I welcome it. I don't have a super big player base on my server. Viewer, I need you to join my Minecraft server. I'm kidding. All right, so I got mail in my mailbox. I formally invite you to tour the Water Tribe. However, I must warn you, we do not like firebenders in our town. For your tour, we will allow them to join for the stream. Other than that, they are banned. So you'll make a single exception for me. That's very kind. I'll get back to that. I'm not in a rush to see the Water Nation yet. Got plans. Please give feedback on the jar located directly north of your jungle gym. Jar! Pretty close likeness. So someone built a giant floating jar with a skin of Bami sitting inside of it. It's not filled with any liquids, no milk or water. I guess that's just a decoration now. That's just gonna be... Every time I wake up in the morning and look at the sunset, that's what I'm gonna see. Alright. Cool. Is there a second page? No. Oh, I want to go out of my way to mention the stream will probably end around like 10 o'clock. I wanted to do a longer stream, but I promised someone I would help them with a project, so... probably like 2-3 hour stream, and be back like tomorrow, or a day or so. Just thought I'd let everyone know. So this one, this book is called Sanglorians. Your brain might be too tiny to pick up on the numerous nuances in the writing style of Sanglorians. He wrote an entire copy pasta I put in the Discord. Like 2 months ago. I feel bad for your brain having to intricately write down that in a Minecraft book. 10 what time zone? ET. So like 2-3 hours from now. This one is called... Ooh, this is perfect music. I'm gonna turn it up a tiny bit. This book is called Important. Dearest Funkston, please speedrun Titanfall 2. Please. If you want slash need help with certain tricks, skips, movement tech, hit me up. I can coach you when I have time. This is from Zweek, one of the community members who actually speedruns Titanfall 2. And I still have not tried running it. To be honest, I'm just mortally terrified of streaming single player games, which is one of the main reasons. But I feel like a speedrun is an exception. There's a lot of interesting stuff to explain during that. Yeah. I can't give you any meaningful response right now. I can't. Sir Zweek, I promise you I will speedrun Titanfall 2 within the next 14 days. I'll give it my first shot, love. I can't head over heels for you, but it is on my mind. Again, I'm kind of overdue on the next main upload video right now, so... Funkcraft alone is kind of a time commitment. And that's a book I've already read. Alright, I think... I'm eating grapes, by the way. I think that's all the mail for the day. Thank you for sending it in. My 5 Animal Crossing Minecraft villagers that live on this server. I'm gonna need a... mailbox. A mail chest. A mail chest. The most useless thing in nature. Funk, we got Avatar up too if you want to pick one. You mean like it's the server is ready to implement an avatar? I've been thinking about that. I almost feel like just be as the streamer, just by virtue of the server is most populated when I'm streaming, I feel like I should be the avatar, if only for that reason, so everyone sees it. Whereas if it's someone else and I stream and they're not on, well then I guess the avatar's taking a nap, huh? Guess the avatar's stuck in a giant ice sphere. Alright, I gotta decide if there's anything I need to do before we go to PvP. Also, I'm sure more people will probably show up on the server later in the day. Or like an hour or two. Do we have enough for a 5v5? 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 11 players. Do we have enough to play the Splatoon game mode that we have? The Splatoon map? With airbend- or with bending? Or at least a 4v4 match. Also, Tiananmen Square? Really? I don't recall giving you the okay to rebuild Tiananmen Square on my server. It's topical? I guess it is. Okay, give me an eye in chat or on the server if you're down to PvP now or in the next 5 minutes. And give me a nay if you want to hold off like 10 minutes to get your tasks done. Need a head count. I've got 3 eyes, 4 if you count me. 5. 6. Alright, it doesn't seem like we have enough for team-based PvP, but I'm down to go run some skirmishes at the arena. Do we have any new arenas built, or is it just this one here and the Earth Kingdom? And I guess technically the Southern Water Tribe could be used as a really big arena. By the way, I should mention, I'm not going to do exclamation mark speak or really too many gimmicks today. I think I've had my fill for now. We could do 3v3. Would that format work? On the Splatoon map? I didn't build it, so I don't know what it was built for. But if we can go 3v3, I welcome that. I'm gonna have to go to the portal. I won't fly there, that's cheap. I'll scooter over. Why build a diorama of a fictional event? Aren't there videos of people being asked if they know what Tiananmen Square is? Or what, like, the date of it is? And the average person in the country doesn't know. What am I looking at? Do we have a new highway? We're going to... Okay. What's the best arena for us then? You guys are on the server more than me, so... I have to wait for feedback before I can roll out here. I know that we have an Earth... Okay, it looks like we're going to the Earth Kingdom. I was scratching my armpit like a chimp. But I'm here. Fuck, I can't see anything. The rig. Bending arena. That's what I'm looking for. Also, let me know if the stream lags. I was having hella lag, stream lag last time. And I'm hoping it's fixed. I can turn off my shader if I need to, but I don't want to. This is the PvP Splatoon map. For those that don't know what's going on the server, we run a lot of PvP games with our bending. It just consists of different elemental abilities for reference. But someone built a Splatoon 2 map that I guess can also be used for our purposes. I like the use of vines for wall climbing. That's clever. Even though it's probably faster to fly. Are you using Ethernet, bro? I am. Is it lagging? By the fact that no one has responded, I'm gonna guess that we're good. Usually someone yells at me. So, okay. If you're on the server and you want a PvP, next 5 minutes, I suggest you go to the Nether, find the rig teleporter, which you just saw me go to. Head over here. I'll even give you the coordinates. That might help. Negative 530, 80, negative 20. Any players, fly over here or run over here, whatever the hell you do. I'll give you like 3-5 minutes. Not even that much, like 2 minutes. And then we'll start a match. But we're just gonna kill time for a minute while I look around. Funk, do you know wall runs in Project Korra? No, I haven't messed with chi blockers. I guess I could do that now. How do you save your slots? Like save bind. B bind. I'm gonna need. Funk, you can wall run as air, fire, and chi? I can wall run? Me? Little old me. Little funky dude. No, I do not know how to do that. I'm being told apparently airbenders can wall run, which makes sense. Just have a gust of air under your feet. Is that an ability-based thing, or is it a tech-based thing? There aren't really any good walls around anyways. No long, flat ones. Where's me phone? I need to know what the time is. Meow, meow, meow. I sticky keyed. Alright, that must be enough time for everyone to get over here, right? Is this the Caillou theme? This is... Hold on, I'm playing a Nintendo playlist. This is definitely the Caillou theme. Is this like a Yoshi world? Oh, it's the main theme of Yoshi's Crafted World. I haven't actually heard that. I didn't play Crafted World. Alright, can I get an eye for who's here and ready to play? Specifically looking to tag in for a 3v3 match? I'm gonna time set day for the sake of PvP. I got two eyes. I need at least six eyes for us to start a 3v3 match. I have three eyes. And you think after 4 years of doing this, I'd have more than five people to sign up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can fill on the sixth if we need it. I would prefer to spectate because I feel like it's funner to watch on stream. Also, I don't know how to play, so I would like to watch. I think Punkass wants to play, but he's lost. This is the best I can do for you. 5:30, man. I'm told that wall runs were explained in chat, but this chat is... I don't see it anywhere. I'm gonna TP you to me. Just seems a lot easier. Double click with an ability that's not activated with clicking when jumping. Dude, you managed to typo every single time you try to explain something to me. Double click with an ability that's not activated with clicking with... I have no idea what that means. Okay, 3v3. Where should the spawn points be? I'll go... So I guess... Let's get three players on this side. Three players on this side. And I can give you a proper countdown. To my knowledge, it's... So this is like the King of the Hill, right? Hold on, let me get some... fight music on. Some fight songs. Alright, so there's a control point that I think players are incentivized to run towards on the map. But I'm told there's this like really basic timer on it or something. But I think for the most part this is all TDM. It's just last man standing, 3v3. Do we count knockoffs? I didn't build this, so whatever the rules are, I need them fed to me right now. If I'm gonna be doing the commentary on this match, I need to know what I'm watching. So is it knockout? Is it death? Is it objective? No one's giving me answers. Okay, it's team base. It's deathmatch. Let's get three over here, three over there. Stand by the wall, and I'll give you the signal, okay? Right now. 3, 2, 1. Get in position. Do you not hear the intruder alert music?
A red spy is in the base.
I had to. I'm sorry. We have one there. Two. I don't know what to say, guys. I literally don't have enough players to set this up. I assume they're coming over here, but right now we have like five people here. I should have uploaded my Minecraft streams to my main so I could actually fucking populate my server. But then I wouldn't have all my beautiful essays lined up. So I'll give people another like 3 minutes to come here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, we have 6. Can you not hear me? Is my stream not live? Have I not said 3 times to go to a corner and be ready?
Ding, ding, ding!
Move! Oh, I guess these are the actual starting points. And no one was correcting me when I asked where it is. Alright, I'm gonna get in position right here. And if you're about to play, keep eyes on me. Once I start flying away, that's gonna be your signal to start. First, before anything, and I'm gonna send this one out to my Twitch chat. We need battle music. We need a song to play throughout the match. Preferably one of those like 30-minute extended ones. Live and learn. I can't remember if I played that last time during 1v1s. No audio? Please don't start that again. My mic isn't muted. All right. I don't know why I ask chat things anymore. I have to do it myself. What's a good fight song? Keys of the Ruin, Sonic Adventure 2. Pyramid Cave, is that the name of it? That's the name of it. Okay, on my mark, when I start moving in-game, that's your signal to start fighting. 3v3. 1, 2, 3. Begin. Oh, I can't actually discern teams here, so I'm gonna have to work around it. So we've got the firewall coming up to keep the waterbender from getting too close. This is so much to keep up with. So it looks like we've got team one backing up all the way to the spirit portal. We've got team two holding them in the choke. This is a bad position to be in. They don't really have anywhere to hide or run. Side note, after this match, we should probably give team colors. We'll call this a warm-up. We've got a dogpile in the middle of the map. Oh wait, I'm totally forgetting something super important for this.
Question, don't answer, it's gonna station the whole got seismic buffs, it's still this little bit makes you wonder. Okay, never mind.
I think the problem is my announcer voice is the gain is too low. So I'm just gonna go back to normal. Just normal technical difficulties during an esports. Punkass wasn't even playing. The whole point of you coming here was to be on a team. I'm not prepared to referee this scenario. Were there illegal shots? Did we have bowfire going off? Hold on. I'm trying to whistle, but I don't know how to do the finger whistle. Yellow flag! Hold on. Yellow flag! Yellow flag! We've got an illegal move on the field! Do we have a bow user? I'm hearing that Punkass was using the default Minecraft bow. I'm going to let him off the hook for now. With the knowledge, that was the first round, and we did not establish rules. But for the future matches, you cannot use a bow and arrow. Do not use an fucking bow and arrow for the element-based PvP. Thought it was pretty obvious, but there's your one warm-up. No, you know what? Yeah, no Minecraft weapons. No swords, no hoes, no axes, no problems, okay? Nothing gets through. I don't even want to see you beating someone over the head with a pumpkin. Funk, could I get a MC whitelist? I see your Twitch whisper, but I can't tell if you're a Twitch sub. And the server is primarily for that. I'm honestly I'm starting to think maybe... I'm open to the idea of having a non-sub server. I'm worried about performance, though. So maybe the server could be sub only, but we could have like once a week events where we make it non-sub. That way we can actually have like a player base. You are? Okay. It doesn't show your badge when you DM me. In that case, I got you, man. There you go. Alright, I'm gonna time set day. If you want to play in the next match, get to the spawn position and be ready for my countdown. And I'll give you another one. Also, after this match, I want to play. I still have not done any PvP on the server. This is probably the best time. Alright, head count. 1, 2, 3. Head count. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Looks like we're ready. Also, anyone else on the server that wants to spectate, feel free to come here and stand over the glass. That way, you don't mess with the match. Alright, I'm gonna queue up a song. What's the best Splatoon 2 song? Does anyone know what that Splatoon 2 song is? The one with the banjo. Well, that doesn't really help me find it now, does it? Ebb and flow. I like the sound of that. Nah. Not hard enough. Tidal Rush. I can work with that. It's a little like orchestraic, but that might actually be pretty cool. I'm going to give you the countdown on the server. One. Two. Three. Go! You're good. I need to come up with a better system for marking. You know what we need? We need a dispenser that shoots out fireworks. Or I guess I could just shoot upwards. Alright, I'm gonna turn that down for a second. Alright, right off the bat. We've got Mora pretty much controlling the map with his flight and his fire jet. That height advantage is going to make it especially difficult, especially with that lightning ready. It makes it really easy for him to perch up on high spots and take pot shots at unsuspecting enemies. But we've got so much going on, people getting knocked off, that he might not get a good opportunity to actually do damage. Meanwhile, we've got one of the players sitting at back in the spawn room. I guess they're saving a life, saving a stock. Ooh, we've got one goes down immediately. Again, I'm not keeping track of teams. I'm just waiting for them to stop fighting. Double ice barrage. Taste vengeance, motherfucker. We've got the wall barrage coming. The water ring. I'm making up these terms, by the way. I think that's a combustion move. It looks like he's trying to aim it, but he doesn't have a shot quite yet. That or he's just, like, blocking. Oh, okay. What do we got here? Combustion comes in, literally blows up the map, but makes a very convenient escape route for Moonbright, or whoever was stuck in that. That was some Rainbow Six Siege destructible territory. Also, I welcome Twitch chat to, like, fake hype this up with Pogs and Funkers. I want this to be like a real esports commentary. Is that the end of the match? Looks like our winners are Zero Blue. Woo! Zero Blue and Moonbright win the second match of Funkcraft. Bending, Korra, PvP, whatever it's called. Okay, I think I understand now. So when you die, what people are doing is they're just waiting and spawn. That way they don't get in the way of the match. Nice. That was fun to watch, actually. Seeing the combustion attack literally blow an escape hole through this so that the waterbender didn't pummel you to death might have been one of the most giga-brain things I've ever seen, and it was in a Minecraft mod. But I welcome it. Yes, I can TP you that funky dude. So before the next match, I have a question, which again, I'll probably have to figure out on my own. But I think it would be easier if we could label teammates with a team color, like change the name color. Does anyone know how to change name colors quickly in Minecraft? Or is that like a server thing you have to do? Leather armor. We can do leather armor, but I just want any quick system that so that players know who to fight quickly and identifiably. Zweek is gonna tell you. I'm on standby. Oh yeah, I remember I had to do that for the TF mod, but it's been so long I forgot. Do I have to do the whole armor stand thing again? If so, I'll just do leather armor. I'm not sure if leather armor will slow down the game too long because of damage, but it might work. Yeah, anyone on the server that wants a plugin or that wants a TP to the arena, just shout me out and I'll give you one. It's Zero Blue. Oh, it's O Blue. My mistake. I have to fly close to see the lack of a line in between. Okay. You could use scoreboard teams, but it looks like you have essentials and essentials fucks with name colors. So, best thing we can probably do is throw on like a colored hat then, right? So, what if I just got a shit ton of hats and colored them red and blue? Would that be good enough? I pick hats because it's obvious, but it's not too much armor. So much that it makes the game take too long. I need some, background music. Alright, how do you die in Minecraft? Not like die, like... Never mind. I think I got it. Fuck, I need a bunch, don't I? That is redstone. I'm a moron. I thought that was red dye. Alright, do you have to do that? Yep. There has to be a faster way. I know that you can spawn it, but the problem is you have to use NBT tags and commands. And I don't want /give real fun. Leather. Helmet. The problem is when you're trying to give an item that's colored, you have to find the color code. Middle click? What do you mean middle? Oh, you can middle click to... Wow. Thank you. That's useful to know. Is that blue or purple? I might have fucked up. I'm colorblind, so I'm gonna make another. One moment, contestants. Apologies for the holdup. So I'm being told we might have enough for a 4v4 now, right? So who do we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4 spectators. If all of you want to play, or at least... Yeah, if all of you want to play, you can. Just pick a team. We'll have a 5v5 match. You only need one die? Oh, well. Now I have more. Can we do 4v4? That's fine with me, but you're gonna need to get 2 new teammates. Alright, anyone on the glass that wants to play, come to the edge. Manhunt, 10-4th maggot. Come in front of me so I know who is waiting to play, and then I will assign you a team. Any? Is it all spectators? I think these guys just want to watch. Alright, I'm not hearing any no's, so I think we're gonna have to just do a 3v3. I don't think we have any more players that actually want to play. I miss Octo Expansion. Well, get in positions then. I don't know why you're up here, Blue. I'm waiting for everyone to be ready. Like I said, if you want to play, pick a side so I can give you your hats. If you're upstairs, I don't know what to give you. I'm gonna throw... I guess it doesn't really matter. Red hats are going over here. If you want to play, come grab a red hat. I agree with Winter in my chat who just said... And then on this side will be blue hats. And this is my fucked system of knowing who is who. Alright, we've got 3 hats ready over here, 3 hats ready over here, and everyone else is spectating. So we're ready. I'll ask one more time. Does anyone have any requests for battle music? If you're just going to give me repeats or no answers, I'll pick it myself. But I figure I may as well ask. Actually, you know what? Next time I stream this, I'll just come ready with like... 2 dozen battle songs. I do like a suggestion I just got in chat. So, I think we're gonna go with that. Let me double check my audio level. Just real quick. I think I can turn it up. Alright. When the beat drops, the fight starts. 1, 2, 3, go! We're gonna do a nighttime match too. I think this will be like an aesthetic. I have no idea what that sound is, but we've got a fight starting off in the middle of the match again. We've got fire versus water going in the exact nucleus of the map. It seems to be the most favored part of it. I suppose because of the close range, it makes it much more easy to get hits in on your enemy. So trying to bait your enemy over to this side, where they're forced to come close to you, can be a really effective strategy for dishing out a lot of quick, successive damage. But the downside of that is that you end up with these absolute clusterfuck damage balls of fights. But the good news is, with these hats, I can actually kind of tell what's going on. It looks like... Actually, I'm not sure. That guy doesn't even have a hat on. We have a red hat over here, but I think he's about to die. Oh, that's a skeleton. I thought that was a player. That was a skeleton. It looks like the fight is over. Oh, a skeleton killed one of the players. All right, I think the fight's still going. It looks like we've got three red players remaining against one blue. Wait, who died? I don't feel like I should spawn you back. It wouldn't be fair. Let's just let this one end quick. All right. Blue team takes the W. That's a win for the blue. Do you guys have a name? What's your team name? One of you give me a team name. What is this shader? My shader is SM Shaders. Probably my favorite Minecraft shader. Team Blue Balls. Okay. Team Blue Balls has won the match! This is your win screen if you want to do like a little dance or something. Okay, that's good enough. All right, next match, I kind of want to play. So, if someone wants to step out for me, I welcome it. Otherwise, I got to kick someone out. What I recommend is the winning team let me join them, because then I'll have the two better players. Although, technically, a skeleton cheated that time, so it doesn't really count. Oh, before anything, do we have a bed over here so people can spawn point? I didn't think of that. Want to make sure people can get back quickly. That might be kind of hard for getting home, though. We got four? Oh, we have a four. That's perfect. See, the reason I want to do a 4v4... Also, can you toss me your hat so I can duplicate it? Because I'm too lazy to pick out the die again. Come on, fellow human. I'm asking for cooperation. And I'll fly over and get you another red hat. Okay. There's yours. There's yours. And there's mine. I should probably bank my stuff, shouldn't I? All right. Let me go get them another hat real quick. Hat? Give me your hat! Spawn point is the beds at the circle. Yeah, I figured that out. Do we have enough? We had more hats, but they're all gone. I guess everyone stepped out. All right. That should be enough. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're ready. Any, song requests? Last battle from Cave Story. Does anyone have any good Tohu songs? Any good anime boss music? Payday 2. I can work with Payday 2. Okay. We're gonna do a Payday 2 song. I'm not entirely sure how to do this countdown. I guess I could just... Fireworks and then fly back and then actually, I have an idea. Hold on, I need to go set my spawn point. Alright. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'll give you the signal with one of those. When you see that go off, match begins. And when the music drops, you know that though. So sorry. This is a super scuffed stream. All right, get ready. In the next 10 seconds, we're beginning. And again, Twitch chat, I know that it's not super interactive for you, but if you want to have fun, spam some stupid Twitch emotes, pretend you're watching an esports stream, just really ham it up. One, two, three, one, two, three, let's rock out. I won't use flight. All right. So I have, for reference for viewers, I have yet to PvP at all on this server, which may show. It may show. And I'm on blue team. Let's go. Funk with some quick thinking is going to put out the fire on him by falling into the water and then flying right back in. By the way, it's not knockout rules. If you fall out, you can get back in. Just don't heal. No eating, no potions. To the death. Okay. I guess meditation doesn't count as that, though. Also, I guess team damage is on. Alright, I don't know what Gale Gust is. For the record, a lot of these abilities have deeper tech that I'm not quite tuning into. Oh no! I need backup! Team! I need backup! I was frozen today! After this match, I'm turning off my shaders to optimize frame rates. Oops. I flew into a wall and died. Okay, I'm out. Well, I forgive chat for not spamming pogs like I asked you to. I didn't really earn it. Yeah, I only instinctively flied because I flew back and then I was trying to get back quick. But then I realized, wait, I shouldn't use fly. But then I... Whoa! Seismic tossed into a death. I'm going to use this time to learn what some of my abilities do. What is... Holy shit. There's so many abilities. Sorry, I know there's not a good angle for you to watch, but... BH Gale Gust. Create a very strong and sudden wind to blow away enemies. Oh. So it's like a poltergeist, but opposite. Alright, the fight is still going on. Looks like we've got... Let's get a head count going. One red player remaining. Looks like we've got three or four blues. That might actually mark the grave for that red team. Helmet goes down. Oh, that's why they were lost. Oh my god, never mind. The red team was just hiding, I think. It looks like the red team is all here, but they're playing very discreetly. So we've got a couple of... There's not really any long-term strategy being played out in front of me right now. We've just got a couple of waterbenders controlling the choke doorway. I wish I had x-rays on. Wait, can I do that? Can I affect outline... I was trying to give everyone an outline so I would know where everyone is at all times. Then other people can see them. Yeah, but I don't think that's a big deal for a game mode like this. That's like... This is basically like Smash Bros, but with three dimensions. Not really. I guess it's to the death, but it's a fighting game, right? It's more of a fighting game than it is a team-based. It's Spectre. Don't need to hear that. Effect. I think the match is over, so I'm going to stop for a moment. Give at a... No? Wait, it might be glowing. Nope, that wasn't it. Effect. Clear at A. Good match. Hold on. I'm sorry, I forgot to give you your celebration. The blue balls have won once again, I think. I can't even remember what team I was on. Sir, do you have anything to say for your big moment?
Gaming.
Funk, you can give different colors for the glow. I get that, but I hit the glow effect and it didn't add a glow at all. Look, effect, give, add a glowing. And then, what, like, 100? It seems glow. Oh, yeah, it might be my shader. I didn't even think of that. Plus, I did say I would turn it off anyways. Oh, wow. I just got way more frames, and I can see everyone. That's way better. Okay, before anything, I think we should give teams colors. Give at a... Hold on, I might have to do some command block shit. Game mode, creative. Give... Real funk? Command block. And bedrock. So, what I was planning on doing is making a hittable button that would only provide outline to the nearest five whatever players. That way, I don't have to manually give everyone. And you know what? I could also make it give them the hat that they need. I could totally just steal the thing that I used from TF2. Alright, I'm sorry, it's been a little while since I've done Redstone, so you'll have to give me a moment. You'll have to give me a second moment to find some epic music to put on in the background. A Rainy Sky, OST. Sure. Alright. So, I guess we'll call like a 5-minute break because it's going to take me some engineering to set this up. But I promise we will resume with more matches right after this is set up. Which shouldn't take too long. And then if someone wants to write, that's like a helmet and outline thing. Just to be safe, I don't know like I don't know what could possibly go wrong if a player gets access to a command block, but I'm just gonna be extra safe here and make sure that it cannot be taken. What music is on? What was just playing was minigame instructions from Super Mario Party. And currently it's Mystic Journey from that Mario Rabbids game. Okay, let's see. We're gonna have to run pretty quick on this. What am I? What's... Is this like a new thing? Okay. So, I need to / give at P, nearest player. Fuck. Hold on, I might have to Google something. So, when you're trying to make a command block that gives a colored armor, you have to get a very specific ID code for the color and then apply it as a it's a whole process. Give colored armor Minecraft. I've done this before, but I well, Zweek did this before, but I forgot how he did it. Alright, oh, I found there's like a Minecraft armor generator website. Sorry for light mode. And that's what I'm looking for. Look, a red helmet. I have to have it display color 16 yada yada. Daze. Okay. Let's test it. That should be a brighter red too. Oh. Can wait, player not found? Oh, did I do it wrong? It's at E. Might have been at E. Oh. What is the at for nearest player? I thought that was at P. At S? No, the give command isn't the problem. The problem is the at. It used to tell you right here, but I think they updated it. Now it doesn't tell you at all. It is P? Okay, then I'm doing something else wrong. Did they change the name of a leather helmet? Is the NBT tag different? No, that's right. Maybe it is that. Is it working, but you're getting it? Still nothing. Look, player not found is the primary problem here. Do I unconditional always active? I might have fucked up. Do you need help? What do you think? Yes, I could use your help. Thank you for offering. If you can tell what I'm doing wrong, I welcome it. Because oh, that's true. I can just give you OP and let you do it. Alright, hold on. Hold on. It's kind of like, it's almost something that I have to be able to do, though. I don't understand. They must have removed at P. What other reason would it say player's not found? What if I did at A? Alright. What if I did that, but in here? Unknown item name. Player not what the fuck do you mean player not oh you know what, I think I might know what it's what I did wrong. I bet it's give leather helmet at A. I bet it's not give at A leather helmet. It's an essentials thing. Okay, first off, Zweek, I'm giving you OP on the server. Admin OP, does that not work? I can't. I don't have console access. I don't think I can give you it. It's being run by a person. Can I see the entire command? Yeah, so this is what I'm trying to do. This is what I have so far. I'm trying to give all nearby players a red leather helmet. You didn't put the name in? That's what at A is. That is the name. Look, at... Wait, OP... Oh, okay. Zweek, you're an op now. I forgot to autofill it. That's why I didn't go through. Essentials suck ass, disable them? I mean, you gotta bring that up with Elder. I'm not running it. If it's on, it was because I assumed it was necessary for Korra, but... If it's not, then I don't see why we need it. Alright, yeah, Zweek, you can give yourself... Oh, he's already doing it. He's already going on. I guess I'll go build the other one, so you can make that. Yeah, that's one of the upsides to having viewers that know the terrain a bit better than I. Okay, and then... God damn it. Give at... Don't you dare! Any mods? We don't have any, like... We have plugins, we have the core one, but no mods, no new items. It's... I've messed with other Minecraft mods where they add new ones and then you have to specify Minecraft in front of the ID tag. Still nothing? I guess what it must just be is there's like some essentials thing blocking command blocks from going through. There might not be anything I can do. Also, it's okay, sewer. Oh, there will be more, and there's a VOD, so if you want to see how it went, you can always look back. Okay, if essentials is breaking anything, we're going to need a new solution. And the only one I can think of is filling chests up with like a dozen of these, and then manually giving people outlines. Or at the very least, giving everyone like a white outline. Do we have another red hat? Okay, yeah, but it doesn't work. Yeah, this is gonna take another minute. I know I said it would take five, but this is racking up into, like, developer territory. So, let's see. I guess I'll... Here's the sticky icky. These chests will be full of leather caps. So, I guess we could also turn on keep inventory on death, but that would mess with anyone that's playing survival right now. Not that I think they'd care. That might be easier. Game rule. Keep innate. Okay, I have to Google it. Unknown item name, leather helmet. So someone in chat sent me a code to try. It did not register. And by removing Minecraft, it doesn't even know what I'm asking anymore. One of the best Pokemon songs, just for the record. Alright, we don't have that many players, so I'll do like just enough that I don't have to keep refilling it in between rounds. Alright, the next match will probably start in like 3 minutes. I think we can work with this. And Zweek can keep messing with that if he wants to. What song? Well, this is a piano cover of it. Oh wait, this isn't even Pokemon. I got it mixed up. This is Prisma Museum from Paper Mario, which I didn't play. It sounds like, I think, Lumina City from Pokemon. But they're the same sort of snowy night vibe. Alright. So, if you want to play in the next match, get lined up at a spawn and grab a hat. I want to play, so I'm going on blue team. And we should be able to start soon. Funk, we would have to disable essentials to do any command block stuff, and I don't think I can do that without stopping the server. Yeah, that's what it seems like, and I don't have access to the control panel, and the guy who runs it isn't here right now. So I think we're just gonna have to endure, and I'll talk to them later about changing it. So we need some red team players, I think. We got two red. Please go to the spawn so that I know who is playing. Because we some people have hats, but they're not waiting for a match. Funk, what are we doing? I was just setting up a faster system for people to get hats, and also I figured out that I can give everyone an outline. But I don't know how to give colored outlines. So why don't we just try one round with white outlines and then just use the hat to verify who you're fighting. Funk, where is the arena? You can reach it through the nether or come to coordinates on screen, or I can TP you if you ask. All right, we got four ready. Four, and then four, counting me. Zweek, first come, first serve. Loser. I'm kidding. I will sit out the next one, but I want to play another without flying into a wall. Okay, battle music. Battle music, chat, chat. URL, give me a YouTube battle music song. Give me your favorite rock track. I don't even care. Doesn't even need to be a video game. Just music. Terraria boss music. I dig it, but that's not, like, energetic enough. That's too ominous. I need something that's very pumpy. Payday 2 soundtrack. Fuck it. Sure. Out of my wheelhouse. Let's go. I'm gonna give everyone the countdown. Once you see me flying back to my spawn, that's when the match starts. You can roll out. I'm gonna be the last to roll out just because of the semantics. All right, be ready. I see too many people. If you're not playing, get off the floor. One, two, three, go, 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 go. Look at that, they're taking pot shots at each other from the bridge. That's smart. I wonder if we could build a viable Smash Bros. Rule set for this game. We would just need to come up with like a recovery system, maybe have some platforms, and then disable damage. Or rather, find a way to have knockback that gets higher with time. Ooh, I'm only using flight to get off the ground. Come on! This isn't thematically fitting at all. Just while I'm listening to this, I just want you to know this is like not thematically fitting to this medieval fantasy setting whatsoever. What's happening? Am I getting knocked out of the air? Someone's air shotting me. Can everyone spam scout, please? Because I saw it once and it made me laugh. Can I get like 300 scout pleases in my chat right now? Oh. Am I the only one alive? You all died. I have a whole team. Ooh. Actually, I think they might be... Okay. That guy is on the gray team. No! You are not going to deny me ring. He's denying me ring. He won't even let me jump back in. Stop! That is not tournament elite. Tournament illegal. It actually is, I think. I think edgeguarding... Actually, I'm making that move. Edgeguarding is legal. Fully embrace Smash culture. Okay, they won, whoever they were. The red team.
The red team has won the PvP bout. There is no reward.
I probably should have thought of a reward in hindsight. I could have made this way cooler. But I wasn't even sure how many people we'd have. I wasn't sure if we would be able to get a 5v5. Now that I know we can get a 5v5, well, I guess I already knew that, but I didn't know if I could get it tonight. I would like to, like, have an actual tournament with some sort of a prize pool. I'm not rich, so I can't promise you anything super cool, but I would love to set up something with some real stakes. So, if we want to run another match, I'm going to sit the next one out to spectate. Also, I thought that music worked well. I don't think, like, if I had a playlist of it, I wouldn't run through all of it at once. I would maybe come back to it, but it did fit. Good BPM. All right, can I get four on each side? Also, I welcome feedback on the format from anyone that's playing or watching. If you're watching and you have ideas on how to improve it, I welcome it. What if we had... Sorry, I know I'm wasting our time for a second, but what if we had, like, a bunch of floating rings at the top of it, and if you fly through the ring, you would get, like, a little, speed boost, or maybe a health heal. So maybe, like, players who can successfully fly through hoops can get, like, a little reward. That's probably a bad idea. Funk, make an item you can only make with commands and use it for a reward. You mean, like, make a custom Minecraft item, and the winner of the tournament gets that custom Minecraft item? How many of you were around for Season 2 of Funkcraft? The one where I built a big castle? The one where I had a stick that would knock players back 100 blocks because players would always run around me, and it fucking pissed me off. So Sinister gave me a stick that literally, like, yeets players away. How would you feel about that as a reward for winning the tournament? You get a yeet stick in Minecraft. Is someone annoying you? Someone on your property? Yeet them. That could be part of the prize pool. I think we could have multiple tiers. That could be one of them. Anyways, for now, what do we got? We got four over here. Does everyone have a hat? Moonbright. Safety first, honey. Please stop swimming on the floor and go put on your helmet. Thank you. Over here. Rare candles, your hat. Okay, you gotta take off the armor, bro. Yeah, there you go. And punk ass, I'm not sure why you're over. What's going on? Are you trying to switch sides? Is this a moment of humblance? Okay, four, stand, like, in the circle. Stand within your circle. Everyone that's not playing, get off the field. I am going to count to 10 or 20 or whatever, and then start the match. Also, Twitch chat, give me a song to play while I give everyone a glowing effect. And don't worry, in the future iterations of this, I'll make sure we have a more streamlined system. You proud? Andrew WK. I haven't heard that name in a while. I'm gonna lose my VOD if I play that. I don't mind Andrew WK. Ping Pong the Animation. Oh yeah, I found my pick. Someone sent me the Ping Pong anime OST. Okay, get ready for the countdown. And again, if you're in Twitch chat, if you want to spam some scout pleases or pogs or whatever terrible emotes you want to like get involved, please type up. Remember, these people are watching. These players probably have the chat open on their screens. So seeing you all go crazy in chat might actually pump the players up a little bit because they can see the crowd too. All right. One, two, three, go. You're ready. You may begin. Immediately, we've got... Oh, we've got a red going in aggressively. I'm not sure why I'm doing a limey accent for this, but... So, to get everyone up to speed, there are no knockout rules. It is to the death. Once you die, you're out of the fight. If you fall down, you may come back in. Actually, play out as normal, but I want to add a new rule to the next one, which is that you can only come up from this side. You can't fly up. I just thought of that rule, and it sounds awful. Looks like we've got one blue keeping to himself. Game mode. Prey mode. Can't... It won't let me fly. I think I'm getting knocked around by someone's hurricane. Okay. So we've got... Oh, I probably should have added on players only. This is kind of nice, though. It's kind of a challenge. Like, you fall down and you have to get back through the trial of all the mobs. So this is the most clusterfuck match I've seen. Oh my god, look at that! So we've got a... Earthbenders are capable of lava bending, which is really powerful for a map like this because it forces non-earthbenders to quite literally walk the coals, especially in certain scenarios like that. Here, it seems to be a pretty... What just... We have a skeleton on the field. I'm gonna allow it. We're gonna call it a stage hazard. Mobs on the field are allowed. If you don't want them there, you gotta kill them yourselves with your abilities. Otherwise, stay away. Looks like the fight's coming back to the choky area. We've got two blues, but for some reason one of them is just leaving. Uh-oh, we might have another corner. There's so much going on. This is pretty much like trying to spectate any team-based FPS game. Can't follow at all what the hell's happening. All I know is it looks like the firebenders and earthbenders are stomping house right now. I don't know why that didn't last long enough, but... Oh, you know what? I think when people die, they lose the glow. Which is actually kind of perfect, because then we know who's out. You lost your glow, right? Yeah, I don't think it matters, since blue team is clearly going to win. Is that it? It looks like the blue balls seem to have won again. Victorious, I can't remember if it was 3, 4, or 5 players. Either way, phenomenal team wipe. You have just sent those guys down to the bronze division of bending MMR. Well done. A winner is you. Funk, since I'm spectating, can I do a little firework at the beginning? Yeah, absolutely. Anyone that wants to add some, like, touches to this, go for it. I am going to set this one to, like a sunset match might be cool. Nice. Okay, I'm taking requests for the next song ahead of time. Star Wars anime opening? That's only a minute long. I need something like at least 3 to 4. Travis Strikes Again. No More Heroes OST. I think that could work. Okay. Do we want a team scramble or anything? Do we want to adjust? I feel like just starting the next match without rotating people is a bad idea. So anyone that didn't play in the last match that wants to play now, meet me. Just meet me here. So that I know who to bench. What about this song, Trust Me Funk? Is this Ben Folds? But for reference, this is an Over the Hedge song. But I had no idea that Ben Folds wrote a song for that movie. That's so fringe. Huh. Good for him. Maybe it was Ben Folds 5, I don't know. Okay, I don't see any new faces unless you count Kojiro. In which case, go ahead to red. I think we'll just do another match. And yeah, I'll give everyone their outline. It's a funk stream. You knew exactly how much of it was going to consist of setup. You knew what you were coming here for. If you have a song that you want me to play, hold it for the next battle, and I will give you the mark. All right, how many people we got playing? Need a head count. Also, I got a rule to establish. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we got 5. Punkass, are you playing? I can be the 5th if you need one. I would prefer to spectate. Funk, it's 9:30. You're going to have to go soon. Probably in the next like 20 minutes. So we have time for a few more matches. First, I need head count. Punkass, are you playing? If not, you need a helmet on. Okay, I guess I will play since I don't think we have a 5th. All right, so a couple things. That Funky is going to set off some fireworks. If you see those, that's going to go off when I announce the start, when they hear it. Secondly, and this is a pretty important rule, no flying back onto the stage. If you fall off, you have to walk over here and then jump back on. Capiche? I don't have a super good way to enforce that yet. So, you know, but the rule that I'm enforcing is you have to come off from the King of the Hill spot. And you are also allowed to camp it. But for reference, like when I mean get over here, I mean that like you can fly up here and then fly wherever. You just have to take off from the grass over here. Not from the water. That's it. Do slash home when you fall off. That also works. If you slash home, that should send you to your spawn point. So, if anything, you could do slash home now, and then whenever you fall off, just type it quick. But the core thing to remember here is if you fall off, don't fly right back up. Also, if that's really unfun, then I'll change the rules, but I want to try this. Okay, be ready. Everyone be in positions. And I'm going to be on blue team. What about earthbenders? Well, same rule. You have to take off from the grass, but you can land wherever you want. If you want to go to the grass and jump over here, you can do that. Okay. I'm going to do one circle around to notify everyone that we're starting. 1, 2, 3, go. The match begins. Sorry if this hurts you. I think I just hit all of my teammates with my scooter. I didn't think about that. Yes. One knocked off. Nice. That's perfect. All right, let's find the remainders. Oh wait, I'm creative mode. I'm sorry. That's cheating. I totally forgot. I'm sorry. We haven't established spawn camping rules, so I'm just gonna like see what I can do here. I'm not seeing enough scout pleases in my chat. Post it as much as you want. I'm just kidding. Uh-oh. Oh, no! Okay. It was a little cheap of me. Oh, God! I need to escape and meditate for a moment. Yeah, it was kind of a bad idea for me to fly. So my meditate can actually passively heal me. But it takes a moment of literal meditation in order to get it. But it is technically still legal. I'm surprised I haven't fallen off yet. Oh, I should also clarify, if you get knocked to the side, but you have, like, a recovery, like a fire jet, you're allowed to use that. So don't be afraid to, like, get knocked off and then fly back in. But if you actually hit the water, if you fall and you don't recover in time, then you gotta walk. If anything, we'll probably need to make a faster system to get back. Oh no. I'm glad I turned outlines on. Don't know what team you are.
How about that?
Whoo, I'm so glad I meditated. I crouched. Fuck. This is just the autoplay on YouTube, by the way. It's more No More Heroes music. I can't follow. How many do we have left? Maybe that rule was a little too much. It seems like the matches take way longer now. Bonk. Wait a second. I feel like we could come up with a more interesting rule set. I like the idea, I like the gimmick of if you're knocked out, you have to do something, but I don't know if just walking back is enough. Like maybe if we could somehow have a counter of how many times someone hits the ground, we could do like a whichever team knocks out the enemy 300 times. We could do like an attrition thing. We could Titanfall 2 it. We could mix Titanfall 2 and Smash Brothers. Titanfall 2, or Smash Bros. Attrition. So have I died yet? I think I died. I can't even remember. It looks like they won.
Red team has won.
What's your name, Red? It's the Fire Ferrets, I'm guessing. The Flameo Hotmen. How long did it take you to make the map? I didn't make this map. Someone else on the server did. And I don't actually know where the credit is. Hold on. There's a spectator lounge. Well, it was made by one of my viewers. I didn't really have a hand in it. I'm just borrowing it. And I was looking for a sign with their name, but I can't find a credit. Okay. I feel like Slash Home. The reason I like the knockout is because earlier when I got knocked out, Blue was on the edge guarding me, and I thought that was kind of an interesting dynamic where you're trying to get back in the ring, but the other person won't let you. What if we did like sumo rules? What if the first team to knock out all enemies wins, and you can't slash home, you have to jump back on the field. So theoretically, if you like knock out three enemies, then your whole team can just come over here and deny them from getting back on. Would that be too insane of a rule? I need feedback from anyone hearing my vocal cords, my sound waves. Also, I think we only have time for one or maybe two more, because I do need to head out by 10. Don't care. Don't care sounds good. That would be dumb. Okay, it sounds like no one has an opinion on my idea, so let's run another... Let's just run another match, standard. Everyone that wants to play, get in the circle, and I will give you your heads up. And if someone can fill in on Blue, I would like to spectate on the next one. Because I don't really... I want to get an overhead view. But I know, it's not always like that. All right, head count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. We might have to go back to a 3v3. Also, nice one, idiot. Funk, should we move the beds to that area? Oh, you mean down here. You mean set the spawn points down here. That could work. We don't need to do that right now. That's something we can do when I have more time or off stream. Okay, can we do a... Would you guys be alright with a 3v3? Because I don't want to play... Well, actually, one of you just move over there. One person from red, join blue. Fuzzy Mike?
Is it fuzzy now?
Like super crackly? We can do a 4v4, but we're gonna need someone to swap teams from red. I know that Mike muted is a meme, but I literally sometimes I wonder if I literally can't be heard by people. When I say seven times, someone join the other team and you're all still sitting there looking around waiting for something to do. Someone from red, join blue, please. I don't have enough authority on my own stream. Mike is fucked up. I'm not entirely sure what the case is. Hold on. Any better? Funk, we have four red? Yeah, now you do. Get your hat on. Hello? Still crackly? You good? Also, we have 4v4 ready. I was just waiting on someone to put their hat on, but it looks like we're good. Bit loud. Oh. At least this happened at the end of the stream instead of at the start of it. Okay, looks like we're ready. So I will give you the flight. Same thing. I'll run a circle and announce on stream when we're starting. First, I'm going to look in my Twitch chat for music to play. Duel of the Fates. Do I really want to play Phantom Menace music? Yeah, I kind of do. Hold on, I'll look at a couple more of these. Especially because I know I won't get through them all tonight. Hotline Miami 2. I like that one more. We're doing that. Okay. when the Hotline Miami 2 jams begin, that will be your marker to begin. But first, if you're not fighting or doing the fireworks, get off the stage. You. Hold on. What are you doing? Buddy, you got to start at the starting area. If you start over here, then you don't have to cross that, which is like what everyone needs to do. All right, get ready. Next 10 seconds. Hold on, it gets really loud really quickly, so I gotta make sure my audio level isn't like too loud. Okay, are we ready? On three, two, yellow flag. One. When the music starts, begin. Begin. Immediately, we've got red funneling to the middle of the map, trying to, I guess, just split up blue team here. It's knocked out of the map. Gonna get edge guarded a little bit, but it's not enough. All right, it seems like there's two split fights here. We've got a 2v2 going on at the left slime block. I'm not sure what the call out for this is, for boxes. And then we've got, what is that, a 1v2 going on? A mid-air 1v2 going on the rafters. So we've got a couple of interior fights going on right now. What the fuck? Oh, that's weak spectating. Water Castle is taking control of the dead center. There. It looks like the Earthbender is trying to lava bend below it, but the problem is that Water Castle is immediately dispersing the lava. So it's kind of a direct hard counter. Lava is not going to be enough to break through that defense. They're going to need, I guess, to jump through the top of the weak spot. But there's no way you're lobbing under that water. We got a couple back alley muggings happening. There's someone swimming. Yo! Combustion. Just 9-11 right into this fight. Too soon? Whatever. Blue is in the corner against, I don't even know what. Just a shit ton of reds. This guy doesn't have a hat on. I'm a little confused by the missing hats, but they're still outlined. Is that it? It's not a castle, it's called Octopus Arms. I'm so sorry. I still see a couple fights going on left. I'm just trying to follow along. What's happening? Oh no! Was that a DC to end the match? Is that it? I think that was the last blue alive. How fortunate. What a way to win. Fire Ferrets take the match. Peppa, Piggy, Mr. Mora, I think Kojiro, and someone else, I don't know. I'm not keeping tracks. I gotta go. Alright, take care. Thank you for playing tonight. Yeah, what time is it now? 9:40. I gotta start wrapping up here, folks. Like I said, I promised someone my time tonight for a project, so I can't.
My eyes! They took my eyes!
But I will be back on, I'm gonna go ahead and go back to my base. Thank you everyone for showing out. Do you guys wanna like all huddle together for a group photo? For a skirmish match? You can come do that if you want. Yeah, again, sorry that it's still kind of a shorter stream. I know I've been doing a lot of those. I plan on doing like a longer, like 3-4 plus hour, so I can really get stuff done another day. I think my schedule's weird tomorrow, so you can expect me either on Sunday, Monday, or Tuesday for the next stream. I mean, I'll still like be on Discord and Twitter, and maybe like a Fatunk upload or something in the near future. But right now, next stream is in like 2 or 3 days. Just letting you know. Okay. Group photo. Huddle. Huddle together. Oh my god! B! Air shield! Whew! Nice try, bitch. I came prepared. I brought my vacuum. Please show the water tribe before we leave. Okay, but I gotta move like quick. Not that quick. BB flight. Alright. Following everyone else here. Because I got no clue where the water tribe is. Is this it? Two water tribe. It's quite fitting. Quite comical, I would say. Quite comical indeed. What's the point of that? Why the fuck do you have an incline on your boat highway? That's just to be an asshole. That's just to be a dick. Funk, Ben Folds did most of Over the Gate? I cannot believe that. Ben Folds was a major contributor. For sir, the carpool lane is in the left side. Do you know what an HEV lane is? God damn it, there's so many distractions. Well, I didn't expect that of Ben Folds, that's all. God damn it, I'll just fucking fly there. I get it. This sick joke. Door stuck. Let's go. That's too fast. That was too immersive. Okay, I've been here before, back when it was just the main buildings. I have not seen the up-to-date. Is there any Water Tribe music? Water Tribe music. Waterbender fan-made orchestral. Well, there's the entrance to the Northern Water Tribe music soundtrack. From the actual show. Like how it does in the show with the lighting. Very orange. Ooh, what do we got here? Huh. Yeah, this is what the Water Tribe looks like in the show, too. It's kind of weird that they have these constant flowing rivers, even though, I mean, it's not weird because they waterbend, but it's weird because it's not for transportation like you would think. Get a nice cool mid-air view of everything. Aww, you even built little Fire Nation battleships. I think that's a Water Nation ship, actually. Yep, it's wooden. Firebender wouldn't be caught dead on one of these rinky-dink pieces of charcoal. Funny mic'd. Why did it funny mic? I didn't click anything. Wow, you weren't lying. I really did funny mic. I'm sorry. Exotic materials. It's a little stand. What is this? Anomalies? What is this a reference to? Anomalies. Like a bloodbending thing? Relics. Yeah, that's a relic. Earth, water, fire, air. Man, this is pretty cozy, actually. You got the ice windows and everything. I'm just looking around right now, looking for stuff. I'm looking to be entertained by buildings. Just a villager's house, I suppose. Just a lonesome waterbending family in their natural habitat. What is this? A jail? I didn't violate anything. It's my server. It's my server. I can dry hump the sleeping villagers if I want to. Did I just break something? Okay, so these are just like your custom Minecraft village houses. These are your decoration pieces. I get that. I'll still look around, see what you've done with the place. This is interesting. Seems we have a polyamorous relationship. Good for you. Damn, these hoes polyamorous. Good for them. I can turn the music down. I was making a polyamorous joke. It was hilarious. Alright, we've got another villager. Are there any other major buildings that I don't want to miss? I remember this. The problem was in the show there weren't that many memorable spots. If we built, like, Bossing Say or Republic City, I think there would be a lot of, like, very iconic spots for us to build. But that's something we would have to do, like, as a group. There's no, like, I can see how you built this with you and your friends. Cat on the roof, what he doing? Mainly vibing, I guess. The barracks. Anyways, I'll get back to you. I would love to do, like, a mega build on the server one day with anyone willing to help. But I gotta decide what to build. That was kind of my idea with the tree, but I forgot. Or I got occupied with other stuff. I broke a piece. What piece did I break? Was it fixed? Also, I forgot to get my stuff from that ender chest. Whoops. other tower? Oh, there it is. Grifa. 9:50. Yeah. 10 o'clock's my cutoff. I'm not running late on a due date or anything. It was just my plans for the day is all. Okay, I need to go grab my stuff and then log off. Like, I don't have to grab my stuff. It's in an ender chest, but I would much prefer to log off with my stuff in hand. Actually, is there an ender chest here? Do we have one? Might be easier. Wanted to have the funny oh yeah, now you're Ro. No. If you want to be a part of my joke, you gotta do it on time. To the BPM. To the beat. Yeah, I am in creative, so I could give myself an ender chest, but that wouldn't feel right. I shouldn't even be in creative. That was just because I broke something. I guess I am in a rush, though, so if I can't find one in the next few minutes, then I will probably cheat one in. Speaking of the devil, thank you. That is exactly what I was looking for. Do not, don't you fucking dare. I need food, I can't leave with my stuff yet, or I will get killed. Nom nom nom. Oh, I still have these fireworks. I'm good on food, guys. There's cake everywhere. I'm not lying. It just takes a moment for it to regen. I don't want to pick up my stuff with half health and then just get slaughtered. This is what I mean. I have places to be. Other stuff. So, good enough. Aww.
The council will now decide your fate.
Does anyone have a bottle that we can spin? All I have is a carrot. Whoever the carrot aims at has to kiss me, haha. Whoever the bottle aims at has to take their shoes off and smell their own foot. Cool. Wow, it's fascinating how big you built this. You've got the full spiral and the little theater leading up to the upper area. Was there anything up there I missed? It seemed like it was pretty cut and dry. Work in progress, I get it. How do you like my kingdom? Are you the one that built the bulk of this? If so, my god, dude, this is beautiful. Would love to find an event to host here, like a birthday party or a funeral or both. So a baby is born and then dies, and it could be born and have a birthday party and a funeral all in the same day. I would love to have one of those here. Ooh, my eyes hurt now. This is actually pretty majestic. Just walking out. Bright white snow. firebenders flying everywhere. I'm good on food, thank you. Alright, one last dip in the pond, and then I think I'm off for the night. What a place. Yeah, this was kind of what I meant when I said I would like to have some nights where maybe we take off the whitelist and just let anyone join. I'm worried about lag, but I don't have that many people that come here, so I can't do like the big crazy community builds. I don't have the manpower for it. But maybe if I could get like 50 people here another day, we could knock out another avatar building. But I'll talk to Elder about that another day. Because we would have to, like, back up the server. There's a whole process. Anyways, if you're not a sub, and you've been kind of, like, curious on if you'll have a chance to play, I'll get back to you in the next week. Because I would like to have some more communal events. But that's it for the night. I gotta go. I got somewhere to be. Next stream will be within the next 2 to 3 days. I don't have a date, but I usually go live 6 or 7 ET. I'm trying to spend most of my time on a video, so streams aren't going to be super planned out. These are mostly just me with my free time hanging out with people. But if you're into that, then I'll see you either Sunday, Monday, or Tuesday. Maybe multiple. We'll see. But that's it for the night. Hold on, I'm saying bye to everyone on my server. Time do we have? 2 minutes? I'm gonna turn on exclamation mark speak for the last 2 minutes until 10 o'clock. Just because I like the interaction of talking to it at the end of the stream. And hope it's not loud as fuck. Oh, never mind. There's no one in my chat anymore. Okay. Bye.